Hello students, welcome to my class. In today's class, we will learn some more questions based on the topic circles. So here the first question, xy and x dash y dash are two parallel tangents to a circle with the center O and another tangent AB with point of contact C intersecting xy at A and x dash y dash at B. Prove that angle AOB is equal to 90 degrees. So this is the diagram. We have a circle with the center O and we have two parallel tangents. So this tangent XY and tangent X dash Y dash are parallel tangents. And we have another tangent. This AB is also a tangent to the circle. So this tangent AB intersects the other parallel tangent at the point A and B, and the point of contact is C. So we have to prove that this angle AOB is equal to 90 degrees. So this is what we have to prove. Angle AOB is equal to 90 degrees. So for proving this, first let us join this O and C, we will join. So first thing, we will join OC. Now if you see here, we got here two triangles, that is triangle OPA and triangle OCA. So the next step, we are going to prove these two triangles are congruent. So, we'll consider triangle OPA and triangle OCA. So, how can we prove these two triangles are congruent? So, if you listen here, this OC and OP are the radii of the circle. So, we can say that OP is equal to OC. Reason is radii. So, radius are equal. Now next one, if you see, A is a point outside the circle and these two are, that is AP and AC are the tangents drawn from an external point A to the circle. So the length are equal. So we can write AP is equal to AC, reason length of the tangents are equal. Length of the tangents from an external point are equal. So, we can say that AP and AC are equal. Now, if you see the third side OA, OA is common for both the triangle, that is OA is equal to OA, which is a common side. Now, if you see all the three sides of these two triangles are equal. So, by SS congruence criteria, we can say that these two triangles are congruent. So, by SSS congruence rule, we can write triangle OPA is congruent to triangle OCA. Since these two triangles are congruent, this angle and this angle are equal by CPCT, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. So we will get angle AOP is equal to angle AOC. So we will get these two angles are equal. This is our first equation. Now if you consider, similarly we can consider these two triangles, that is triangle OQB and triangle OCB. So the same argument, we can say that these two triangles are also congruent by SSS congruence. So we will get these two angles are equal, that is angle QOB is equal to angle COB. This is the second equation. Now if you see, here in the question it is given that the tangents XY and X dash Y dash are parallel tangents. So this line PQ is the diameter of the circle. So diameter means this is a straight line. So the sum of all these four angles will be 180 degrees because this is a straight line, straight angle. That is, we can write angle AOP plus angle AOC plus angle QOB plus angle COB is equal to 180 degrees. Now from equation 1 and 2, instead of AOC, we can write angle, instead of AOP, we can write angle AOC. So in this place, we will write angle AOC. So angle AOC plus angle AOC plus angle, instead of this QOB, we can write angle COB. So angle COB plus angle COB is equal to 180 degree. That is, we will get here 2 times angle AOC. So here we are getting 2 times angle AOC plus 2 times angle COB is equal to 180 degree. If you take 2 outside and bring it to right side, then we will get angle AOC plus angle BOC is equal to 180 by 2, that is 90 degree. Now you see here angle AOC, that is this angle, plus angle BOC, BOC means this angle. So sum of these two angles is nothing but angle AOB. So we can write angle AOB is equal to 90 degree. This is how you have to prove. So question number 2. A triangle ABC is drawn to circumscribe a circle of radius 4 cm such that the segments BD and DC, into which BC is divided by the point of D, point of contact D, are of length 8 cm and 6 cm respectively. Find the sides AB and AC. So here in this question, we have a triangle ABC. And inside the triangle, we have a circle of radius 4 cm. So we have the radius of the circle is 4 cm. And this BC and BD. So here we have this point D. And the length of BD and BC are given as 8 cm and 6 cm. So these two lengths are given as 8 cm. BD is 8 cm and CD is 6 cm. Then we have to find the other two sides, that is AB and AC, we have to find. So here, for finding these two sides, we will use the concept, area concept we will use here, area of triangle ABC. That concept only we are going to do now. So let these two points, we will denote this point as A and this point as E and F. We will denote these two points as E and F. Now we do know this length, so we will take this length as X. That is, let AE is equal to X. Let AE is equal to X. But here A is an external point to the circle, and this AE and AF are the tangents drawn from the external point A. So their length are equal. So this X, AE is X, therefore AX is also X. Now the same way, C is an external point from which we have drawn two tangents CD and CE. But we have CD length as 6 cm, so CE is also 6 cm. The same way here, BD is 8 cm, so BF is also 8 cm. Now we are going to find the area of this triangle using Heron's formula. So for Heron's formula, first we have to calculate the S, that is semi-perimeter. That is, we will add all the sides and divide it by 2. So we will take, first we will take side AB. AB is now X plus 8. So X plus 8 plus BC. BC is 8 plus 6, that is 14. And AC is X plus 6. So divided by 2. So S is nothing but semi-perimeter. So divided by 2. So when you simplify this, 2x plus 28. When you add 28 by 2, that is, you will get as x plus 14. So we got semi-perimeter. Now we know that area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC using Heron's formula. The formula is square root of S into S minus A into S minus B into S minus C. Here A, B, C are the sides of the triangle, length of the sides of the triangle. So we will simplify what is s minus a, s minus b and s minus c. We will see now. S minus a, yes, we got here 8 plus 14. So sorry, x plus 14. So x plus 14 minus this side we will take as a, that is x plus 8. So when you simplify this, this x will get cancelled and you will get 14 minus 8 is equal to 6. You will get s minus a as 6. Then the same way we will see what is s minus b value. S is x plus 14. B is next side, that is this side length is 14. When you cancel, simplify this, you will get a value as x. So s minus a, s minus b we have calculated. Now we will see what is s minus c. S minus c also we will calculate now. That is x plus 14, x plus 14 minus, you see x plus c, s minus c is equal to x plus 14 minus c is nothing but this side, that is x plus 6. So we will write here x plus 6. When you simplify these two, xx will get cancelled and 14 minus 6 is equal to 8. So we got now s minus a as 6, s minus b as x and s minus c as 8. So these values we are going to substitute here. So which is equal to root of s is x plus 14. So x plus 14 into s minus a is 6. 6 into then s minus b is x. X into s minus c is 8. So we got now area of the triangle. We have calculated now area of the triangle using Heron's formula. So this is the area of triangle ABC. Now we are going to, so we will join. Now we are going to find the area of triangle ABC using, see if we are joining the points OA, OB and OC, we are getting three smaller triangles here. If you add the area of these three triangles, that is triangle OAC and triangle OBC and triangle OAB, if you add these three triangles area, then we will get the area of triangle ABC. So now we are going to find the area of triangle ABC using this method. We are going to add the area of these three triangles. So again we will write area of triangle ABC is equal to area of first this triangle we will take. So area of triangle OBC plus area of triangle OAB plus area of triangle OAC. Now we will find out the area. Now each triangle's area we will find out and we will add now. First you consider this triangle OBC. Here this is the height. So height is nothing but the radius of the circle, which is given in the question as 4 cm. So we can use half BH formula for finding the area of each of these smaller triangles. So half into, here for this triangle base is BC, that is 14 into height is 4, plus half into for the next triangle OAB, for this triangle base is x plus 8. X plus 8 into, here also height is nothing but the radius, that is 4 into 4. Plus half into, for this triangle also the radius, height is nothing but the radius, that is 4 into base is x plus 6. So we will get here the area of the three triangles. Now we will cancel here, we can cancel and we will simplify now. When you take these two, we will multiply, so we will get 28 plus, here we have a 2x plus 16, we will multiply by 2, so 2x plus 16 plus here we have a 2x plus 12. Now when you add all these numbers, the values, we will get 4x plus, so 28, 30, 40, 56 we will get, that is 4 into x plus 14. So this is the area of the triangle using another method. So we got the area of the triangle using two methods. Now we are going to equate these two because we know that these two are the area of the same triangle. So we are going to equate now. So we will do now. Next we will continue. We are going to equate equation 1 and 2. So what we have 1 here is root of x plus 14 into 6 into x into 8. So this is from equation 1, area of the triangle. So from the second equation, area of the triangle is 4 into x plus 14. So from these two equations, we got the area of the triangle and we have equated also. Now we have to simplify this for getting the value of x. So here we have a square root. So squaring on both the sides. So squaring on both the sides. So the square root will cancel in left side. So x plus 14 into 6 into x into 8 is equal to here 4 into x plus 14 the whole square. So here we will take the square for both 4 and this x plus 14 factor. So here we will write x plus 14 into 6 into x into 8 is equal to 4 square, that is 16 into x plus 14 the whole square. Here we can cancel 1 x plus 14 and here also we can cancel 1 factor. So we will get only 1 x plus 14 and this 8 and this 16 also we can cancel. Now what is remaining in the left side is 6x is equal to the right side we have 2 into x plus 14, 2 into x plus 14. That is 6x is equal to 2x plus 28. Then we will simplify this. So 6x minus 2x is equal to 28. That is 4x is equal to 28. So x is equal to 28 by 4 is equal to 7. So we got the value of x now as 7. Now we can find out the side AB. So AB is nothing but x plus 8. So we got now x value as 7. So 7 plus 8 is equal to 15 centimeters. So the side AB is 15 centimeters. Now the side AC. Side AC is x plus 6. So x plus 6, x we got as 7. So 7 plus 6 is equal to 13 centimeters. So here we got the other two sides, AB and AC. Number 3, prove that opposite sides of a quadrilateral circumscribing a circle subtend supplementary angles at the center. So here in this question, we have a quadrilateral ABCD circumscribing a circle with the center O. So you have to prove that the opposite sides of the quadrilateral subtend supplementary angles at the center. So if you join the vertex of this quadrilateral, so you have to prove that angle AOB plus angle COD. So these two are the opposite sides. The opposite sides subtend supplementary angle at the center. So we have to prove here angle AOB plus angle COD is equal to 180 degree. Same way the other pair also. That is angle AOD plus angle BOC is equal to 180 degree. So this is what we have to prove here. So for proving this, first we will name these points as P, Q, R, S. So these points we will take as P, Q, R, S. And here we will join these points, that is P, O, O, Q, O, R, O, S. We will join O, P, O, Q, O, S, O, R. So these points we will join. And the angle obtained we will name as 1. This is angle 1, 2, angle 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So now we have 8 angles here. Now we are going to consider these two triangles first. That is triangle OPA and triangle OSA. So these two triangles we will consider first. Triangle OPA and triangle OSA. If you consider these two triangles, here this OP and OS are the radius of the circle and this AP and AS are the tangents. So we can say that these two angles are 90 degree because the radius is perpendicular to the tangent. So these two angles 90 degree we will get. That is angle OPA is equal to angle OSA is equal to 90 degree. And we have this side OP and OS are equal. So OP and OS are the radii, so that will be equal. Radii of the circle. So OP and OS are equal. Now this AP and AS, the length of the tangents are equal. So AP and AS are equal. And OA is equal to OA. OA equal to OA is the common side. Common side of both the triangles. So in these two triangles, we got all the three sides are equal. So by SSS congruence, we can say that these two triangles are congruent. So by SSS congruence, we can say triangle OPA is congruent to triangle OSA. Since these two triangles are congruent, we can say that angle 1 is equal to angle 8 by CPCT. So we can write now angle 1 is equal to angle 8. Angle 1 is equal to angle 8 by CPCT because these two triangles are congruent. So we got this. The same way we can consider these two triangles and we can prove that these two triangles are congruent by SSS congruent. So we can say that these two angles are equal, that is angle 2 is equal to angle 3, and the same way for other angles also we can prove the same way. Angle 4 is equal to angle 5, angle 6 is equal to angle 7. Angle 4 is equal to angle 5 and angle 6 is equal to angle 7. Now if you see, angle around a point is 360. We know that angle around a point is 360. So we can write angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6 plus angle 7 plus angle 8 is equal to 360. Now we will group the angles, that is angle 1 and angle 8 are equal. So these two angles we will group, that is angle 1 plus angle 8. Then these two angles, that is angle 2 plus angle 3 plus next 4 and 5. We will group these two, angle 4 plus angle 5 plus angle 6 plus angle 7. Angle 6 plus angle 7 is equal to 360. Now if you see here, angle 1 and angle 8 are equal. So here in this place angle 8, we will substitute angle 1. So angle 1 plus angle 1, we will get to 2 angle 1. The same way here angle 2 and 3 are equal. So in the place of 3, we will write angle 2, that is angle 2 plus angle 2, that is 2 angle 2 is, we can write it as 2 angle 2. The same way if you see here 4 and 5 are equal. So in the place of 4, we will substitute 5. So we will get a 2 angle 5. The same ways angle 6 and angle 7 are equal. So in the place of angle 7, we will write angle 6. So 2 angle 6 is equal to 360. Now from all these terms, we can take 2 outside. So we will get angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 5 plus angle 6 is equal to 360 by 2. 360 by 2, which is equal to 180 degree. Now if you see, what is angle 1 plus angle 2? If you see in the diagram, angle 1 plus angle 2 is nothing but angle AOB. So we will get angle AOB. And what is angle 5 plus angle 6? Angle 5 plus angle 6 is these two angles. Together we will get angle COD. So we got angle AOB plus angle COD is equal to 180 degree. So in the similarly, we can prove for the next pair also. We can prove similarly. So we will get the finally we can prove that the opposite sides of a quadrilateral circumscribing a circle subtract supplementary angle at the center. So we will get these two results. Thank you, students.